Picciano's son, Joseph.
Wow, this is some crowd. Right, Ma? Firstly, I would like to thank my cousin Annie for organizing, petitioning, and knocking down walls to make this event happen. Thank you so much, Annie. So yes, this is the block where we grew up. We played street games here, had snowball fights, waited for the ice cream truck, but there was also tragedy. People often ask, how did we get through it? The answer, we really didn't talk about it very much. We felt that obsessing would actually cause more trauma, and we just dealt. I'm more than 20 years older than my father ever got to be. Yet, when I look at pictures of him, even till this day, I still view them as if he's older than me. It's sort of the strangest thing. And it's also a wonderful thing because, from that perspective, it provides me with the reinforcement of his spirit. My mother, the wise sage, provided us with the best she could in the most unfortunate situation you can ever imagine. Thank you, Mom. You did a fine job successfully raising three loud and proud kids from Queens. And lastly, I'd like to thank the City of New York and the Office of Elizabeth Crowley for their effort. And to thank you all for being here to salute my father's service, mourn his loss, and honor his achievement. Thank you.
Thank you, Joseph. It's now.
to remember and to honor Detective Joseph Piccione. To begin, please rise for the presentation of our nation's colors and the singing of the national anthem by police officer Jason Martinoff.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, our bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, Officer Martinoff. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the invocation by Police Department Deputy Chief Chaplain Monsignor Robert J. Romano.
Let us pray. We come together today to do what we as a police department do very well, and that is to never forget. As we gather here today to honor the memory of Detective Joseph Picciano, we come together to pray for him, that he might have the gift of eternal life. We pray for his family, that they might have the consolation that they need. As we come together today, we pray for all the members of the New York City Police Department, that they might be safe on and off duty. As we gather here today, we are also mindful of the freedom that we have to be here today. And that is won for us every single day by the men and women of our armed forces who serve us so proudly, many of whom are members of the NYPD. Watch over them and bring them home soon. And finally, Lord, we ask your blessing upon all of us who have gathered here on this brisk morning to remember a hero, and that we will always remember and never forget. Amen.
Thank you, Monsignor. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. It's now my pleasure to introduce the members seated on the dais with us this morning. Please hold your applause until all have been introduced. Beginning on my far right is Commanding Officer of the 104 Precinct, Deputy Inspector Mark Wachter. Commanding Officer, Detective Beryl Bronx, Deputy Chief Jason Wilcox. Chief of Community Affairs, Joanne Jaffe. Chief Detective Robert Boyce. Council Member from District 30, Elizabeth Crowley. NYPD Deputy Chief Chaplain, Monsignor Robert J. Romano. Former 4-1 Precinct Commanding Officer and author of Fort Apache, the Bronx, retired Captain Tom Walker. Vice President of the Detectives Endowment Association, Paul Giacomo. In our second row, Commanding Officer of the 4-1 Precinct, Captain Louis DeSigi, and the Patrol Borough Bronx, Adjutant Inspector Nancy Barry. Ladies and gentlemen, this is our dais, and we thank them for being here. It is now my pleasure to introduce the Chief of Detectives.
Good morning, everybody. I'm enormously grateful to be here today at a special event and honored, actually, to be here. And I applaud Councilmember Elizabeth Crowley for her help here and Mayor de Blasio. This is great. This is what we need. About 4 years ago, we dedicated a plaque at the 4-1 precinct, the old 4-1. I'm sure a couple people worked here out of that building, 1086 Simpson Street. And we got to know the family a little bit. It was a very emotional day. So Joe's name hangs there for every detective to walk by that location every morning, as I did for 4 years as the Chief of Bronx Detectives. Now it's going to be outside for the whole world to see. I'm really proud of that, very happy. Joe's sacrifice will never be lost on us. We will always remember him. No matter it's been 45 years, we'll keep remembering every day. And out of Joe's heroic efforts that terrible day, came another hero, a heroine, Teresa Yu. 25 years old, I believe, at the time you were, with Teresa's 29? She said 25.
Three small children you raised in wonderful. We're enormously proud of you as well. You've helped other women as well, please. So we thank you, and I'm going to see you in a week.
Yes.
At the Christmas party, as we do every year here in Dubai. So thank you so much for that and for all you do. And we're never going to forget you. We're never going to forget a single one sacrificed by any of our officers. And today is an important day when we do this together. Like I said, I'm so proud to be the Chief Detective working now, and hopefully all those who retire who came before me as well. I will always have a God bless all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief Boyce. It is now my pleasure to introduce the person who helped make this day possible and helped put all of this together, the council member from District 30, the Honorable Elizabeth Brown.
Good morning. Thank you, Sergeant Harvey. Thank you all for being here today as we honor the legacy of Detective Joseph A. Picciano. We are joined by his wife, Teresa, his three children, Vincent, Joseph Jr., and his daughter, Suzanne, their spouses, and his grandchildren. We are also joined by the larger family of the NYPD, and I want to thank the Chief of Detectives, Robert Boyce, for being here today, our local Deputy Inspector, Mark Wachter, and from the Detective Endowment Association, Paul DiGiacomo. We are also joined by Joseph's partner, retired Detective Richard Ware. On December 14th, 2015, nearly 1 year ago, I received a touching correspondence from Joe's cousin, Ann, requesting that we honor him with this co-naming, recognizing that we as a city must honor Detective Picciano and his legacy. My office and I got to work right away. We drafted a bill, introduced it into the city council, and it was passed unanimously and became law that this block right here would be co-named Detective Joseph A. Picciano Way.
Joseph A. Picciano. They all who come to see this sign know who this great man was, that he was a part of this neighborhood, part of this block, and part of this great city. Lord bless his family. We place this prayer now in your name. Amen.
America, land that I love, stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam, God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my home sweet home.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our ceremony. Family, I want to thank all of you for attending this morning. Please enjoy the rest of your day and have a safe trip home.
Yeah.